Where have all the humans gone, this world seems to say. You know, I'm not quite sure. They began to disappear one day. They polluted all the waters, then they chopped down all the trees, then they poisoned all the air so they couldn't even breathe. Where have all those humans gone, this universe seems to say. You know, I'm not quite sure. They just up and disappeared one day. As one by one began their slaughter of that silly human race, they decided to try again. So they sent them into space. Well, on each of the new planets, they tried their technological game, but it didn't work out much different. Actually, it worked out about the same. So now it's just us universe. Those silly, silly humans are all gone. Now we're left to repair the mess of all that they have done. Everything seems to be healing, slowly but surely, but not quite ever the same. All because those silly, silly humans refused to learn a better game. Considering that the logging and burning of our old-growth primary forests is one of the leading causes of climate crisis, then what would the solution be? To not log and burn our forests. That'd be a good place to start. If only it was that simple, right? Unfortunately, in our world today, we have all these systems in place that create value on a forest being cut down, on a forest being burnt. We only see the value of a forest as a product. Scientists have now been telling us for decades that we have to stop deforestation if we want to slow this climate chaos and help heal this climate crisis. If we want our children to be able to inherit a planet that they can live on and breathe on, it requires us to protect the last of these sacred ancient primary forests that hold so much of what we need to survive, let alone thrive. They're the lungs of our planet, they're the lungs of us. They stabilize the climate, not just for us, but for future generations. These trees have lived to be 2,000 years old, 3,000 years old. Can we imagine ourselves as stewards of something that's 2,000 to 3,000 years old? We need to recognize that we, you and I, we are ancestors of the future. And we need to begin to think, what does it mean to live our lives in a way that impacts generations still to come, most of whom we will never meet? Our choices today are going to either uplift their lives or help destroy them.